Guess what? Exciting things are happening in Canton. Gervasi Vineyard has expanded once again, and today we're talking wine with winemaker Andrew Cutterspotty. I love that name.
Well, thank you. My mom loves it, too.
Was it named after a village or something?
I think they named it after Italy.
After Italy.
Yeah, actually, it has origins in southern Italy, and some have told me that it goes all the way back to Greece.
Great.
But I was born in Italy, and so we just stopped right there.
So now we have Greece.
He's the real deal.
Now we have Italy in Canton.
Honestly, we do. This Gervasi Vineyard has received so much recognition all over the country, and I feel like probably even beyond. I mean, you take Italy and you just really put it right here in Northeast Ohio.
You grew it.
Well, that's our owner, Ted Swaldo. His mother comes from Northern Italy, and I came from Southern Italy, and so we kind of met together in the middle in Canton, Ohio. And he has just done a wonderful job of transplanting an element of the Italian heritage there in Canton.
Mm-hmm. It's gorgeous. And you can't forget about the wine.
I see some corks that are loose in
these
bottles.
Yes. They're ready. And I have two wines that I'd like for us to sample. The first one is our Aromella, which is right here. It is a North American hybrid that was developed by Cornell University so that it would tolerate the climates that we have here in Ohio. And I love this particular wine. It has characteristics of the Muscat grape, if you're familiar with the Moscato. And I'd like to pour some of this for you.
That's a heavy
duty
bottle.
You didn't know you were going
too,
to have both of us here today, did you? I feel bad now. Do you want to sample and I'll sample the next one?
No, I've had
You've had plenty of this. You know what it tastes like.
But if you'll just take a look at that.
Yes, cheers. I don't know what that accent was.
Well, white in a dark bottle like that's sort of unusual, isn't it?
Well, we wanted to have commonality in the presentation for the marketing side. And so therefore, we do it that way. And in addition, a dark bottle will also further protect a white wine from exposure to sunlight and things like that.
This thing has shoulders, doesn't it? It's big for a white wine.
Well, it has a beautiful balance between the acidity and the residual sugar that is in there, complemented by some of the blossom, floral, melon type of, and even honey type of notes that are in there.
Taste the honey notes. It has a sweetness to it. It's not overly sweet, but if you tend to like a teeny sweetness to your wine, this is a great option.
But it doesn't cloy or cloy.
No. Well,
and the whole goal in producing this wine, this came from our estate vineyard. It's grown there in Canton, Ohio. And the intent is to produce a wine with balance so that you have the varietal characteristics of the grape, you perceive the sweetness, but you also have the brisk refreshment that comes from the acidity in the wine. And it's something that's balanced that way, then just really is very comfortable and it feels good.
Perfectly described, huh?
Can you tell he's like, he's a mad scientist there. He's in his, you have your little lab and you get right to work. You really have such a passion and it shows.
If we had had this wine earlier, we would have served it with that crab that you produced. This would be a great.
We could save that for later.
It would be excellent with that.
It would be great. Yeah. Now the second wine that I have is Marquette, and this is our red wine, again, grown on the estate. Marquette was developed by the University of Minnesota, and again, it's a North American hybrid designed to tolerate our inclement weather that we have. And Marquette has in its distant parentage Pinot Noir. Mm. Now, Pinot Noir tends to make a lighter bodied, low tannin wine, but our terroir and the stylistic combination of our winemaking styles produces a wine that is a little richer in body, a little bolder.
It's bigger, huh?
It's bigger, and you're going to find characteristics in there of black currant, hints of vanilla and clove, and maybe even some plum characteristics. And a lot of times people will ask me, well, what's it like? And I say, well, it's not like anything else. It's its own characteristics. But sometimes I will describe it as being a cross between a Merlot and a Barbera. But that only helps if you know what those two are.
Yeah, right. Okay, so we have to say, we're already wrapped, but we have to say a bunch of things. You got a distillery now, you got the still room, and tell them about the new
hotel. At that. We got to show you this video real fast. How beautiful. This is the new boutique hotel that you have on the property, correct?
That is
correct. Brand new. So it's one more place that people can come and stay.
Absolutely. We just.
You don't have to drive home.
No, we just had the ribbon cutting there. And then on the front side of the property is the still house, which is a coffee house by day and a cocktail lounge by night, and the distillery. And I have three of the products here that we just went into production on Monday, and we're producing a bourbon, a vodka, and a gin, and we have another vodka, a rosé vodka, which has a blend of our estate wine in it, and a gin-based product that will be coming out in the next month.
Save some money. You don't have to go all the way to Italy. You just go to Gervasi.
Jump in the car. It's 45 minutes from where I live.
Gorgeous. And it's everything about it.
Everything's always been great, and the wine is fantastic. And thank you so much.
Thank you for coming, and we appreciate it so much.
Well, you're very welcome. We enjoy having you down.